Good. So now with me, Ryan Holmes, founder and CEO of Hootsuite.
Like an owl. Hootsuite.
Yeah, it's Hootsuite. Who let the Hootsuite out? Okay. No, seriously, we're very honored to have you. I know it's your first time here in Cologne at the Mexico. You got a booth?
We have a booth,
and, we were just chatting, and I'm running into more and more people that know your service and your solution. So tell us a little, first of all, maybe, how was it for you the first almost 2 days being at this show or at this venue?
Well, you know, I've been to so many conferences, CES, South by Southwest, CBIT, et cetera, tons of conferences.
Yeah.
The scale of this event is incredible. I could not believe how many halls there were, how many people there were. It's a little mind-blowing, and just to see it all here. So amazing event, some really great conversations. We met up with so many of our customers here and had really, you know, good time to connect with them and learn more about their business and see how we can help them.
Yeah. So are there specific plans expanding, coming from the US, maybe to Europe? Do you have offices in Europe already?
Yeah, we have an office in London. We have a team in Germany. We have we're based actually in Vancouver, Canada. That's our headquarters.
Okay.
And but we have nearly 1,000 employees, 180 in Europe, and
wow.
So we're, you know, absolutely, it's a fantastic market for us. We have really aggressive growth plans over the next year to continue growth to service our customers here.
So you'll probably be back, not here at this venue, hopefully as well, but offices in Germany, clients. Could you drop a couple of names, clients, to get a feeling what kind of companies you serve?
Yeah. So we have some amazing customers in Europe. We have Virgin. We have Accor Hotels, mm-hmm. Sony. In terms of North American scale, over 836 of Fortune 1000. And with regards to the German market, over 22 of DOC 30. So
wow.
Really good penetration into enterprise customers. And, you know, we really look forward to expanding that and you know, getting 30 out of 30 maybe.
So how did you start your career? Where did you start? What was your first job?
Well, that's a fun question. So, like a lot of entrepreneurs, I started my first business. Was pretty much my first job. So I started a paintball games company. So, paintball,
yeah,
guns and going out and shooting your friends. And so that was
you
my
organized
first business.
Events or?
Yeah, well, I bought the guns. I made the playing field. I marketed it, sold it to you know, businesses.
Yeah.
And it was my little mini MBA that I did in high school. And that was my very first business. Learned so much about, you know, serving customers, marketing customers, and running a business in general from that.
When looking at this so-called digiconomy, we got a couple of buzzwords coming up. What do you think will be like the next really true thing that's going to happen? Not the big next thing. Will it be live video? Is it 360? Is it VR? Is it the next level of mobile shopping? What's going to happen?
You know, I think, well, you know, in terms of buzzwords right now that are relevant, digital transformation is happening to everybody. Whether the companies are early adopters into transforming their businesses or late adopters, they will need to do it. I mean,
yeah.
If this was 97, 98, 99, people were talking about, do they need a website? Do they need email? Yes, they need it to do business. And now we're looking at other big trends, mobile, social, collaborative economy, so Ubers, Airbnbs, et cetera, of the world, and then generational trends, millennials that grow up with all of this, as well as, you know, connected consumers, Generation C,
yeah,
which is the people that are always on internet and web and cloud. This is changing how businesses do business with their customers. So that's absolutely a big trend and theme. You know, you mentioned VR, yes, robots, they're coming, all of this. And it's happening quicker than we think. You know, just today, Uber launched out a self-driving fleet of cars officially in Philadelphia.
Wow.
And that is, you know, 2 years ago, do you think that would have happened that quickly?
No
it's
way.
Happening so fast. And so we live at a very exciting time. Forrester said 6% of all workforce will be replaced by robots by 2021. And
that is
coming so fast. So it's going to be a crazy, wild, bumpy ride. And, you know, I hope we can navigate it in a way that works for everybody and it's exciting.
So is tech and even the customer base faster than probably the business cases and the companies rolling it out? Is that what's happening?
Yes. You know, that's where you hear so many more mature businesses talking about how they're trying to foster innovation, mm-hmm. both through acquisition and internal innovation. And it's a huge challenge for them because businesses are evolving so fast. And the next up-and-comer is the business that's going to take you out. Yeah. And so there's a big interest resurgence in figuring out how companies can innovate faster, because you can't just own a taxi company and sit back anymore. You can't just own a hotel chain and sit back anymore. Yeah. You have to innovate because the disruption is happening all around, and you need to think about what your strategy is and how you're going to add value for your customers.
So you're in a field and in a position as an entrepreneur, but also with your services, you have to be visionary in terms of business models, business cases, revenue streams. Where do you get your inspiration from? What is your source for
energy? Social media.
And ideas?
I know. I talk to customers. You know, I spend a lot of time reading about, you know, what is coming up, what's going on. I spend a lot of time reading in general, not just the internet, but longer form books. And it is a very exciting, transformative time. But you see. Ray Kurzweil and others talk about this exponential curve we are on. Humans see things very linearly, but we're really on this type of a growth curve, and that's hard for our minds to fathom what that means and how fast it is going to be moving. I'm just trying to take in as much information from as many places as I can.
So what will be basically the main challenge for you and your crew maybe within the next 12 months?
It will be focus. So we are in there's opportunity everywhere. There's opportunity for innovation to help customers, from customer support through marketing and selling, through employee advocacy, gauging ROI. All of this stuff is a huge opportunity, and you have to figure out where your product starts and stops, and what you want to support. So we're focused on building a platform. And we hope that, and we've already shown that we have partners that are building in solutions into our platform. So our goal in creating the platform is that the solutions come to our customers through the platform. And we're seeing great traction on this. We have over 200 applications built into our platform for our customers, and millions of installs of those applications. And so that'll be a big part of our strategy into next year.
You mentioned one source, or the source, is social media. So when you switch on your smartphone, which means you switch it off somehow, someday, sometimes. Do you, or are you always on?
Not unless the battery's dead.
Okay, so after recharging, yes. You switch it on again. What are the apps you use instantly and on an everyday basis?
Yeah, so I love all of the social networks for different reasons. And we think about ourselves as a kind of social media Switzerland. We sit between Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, a whole bunch of others, Instagram, hundreds of others of longer tail social networks. And none of them is the right thing for anyone, for everybody. They're all specific and beneficial to different brands and different customers in communities. I love jumping in and out of a lot of those. Other than that, I'm always in my Gmail. I spend obviously a ton of time on that. In Calendar, these are not very exciting, but obviously where I am. I love the image based social networks. Personally, Instagram, very fun. Snapchat, very fun. I think that Instagram made a really smart product move recently. Mm-hmm. And then I'm always exploring just a ton of other apps, seeing what people are doing that's interesting on a mobile perspective. And I love product, so I always love figuring out what people are doing.
Interesting times. Interesting business, company, interesting man.
So we'll
keep our eyeballs on you and the company, and see you hopefully
Great.
Next year.
Thanks a lot.
All
Great
the best for you guys.
You bet. Cheers.
Keep our fingers crossed. Cheers.